Ecology, at its most basic, is us studying the relationships between organisms and their environment and organisms with other organisms. But ecologists traditionally have taken people out of that equation. People are integral to this equation. Urban ecology means that not only are ecological processes important, but societal processes are important as well. So we think about not only the amount of temperature gradients that exist, the amount of rainfall that exists in an area, the amount of resources that exist for certain organisms. We also think about how are people moving and navigating these landscapes. And that necessarily means the societal inequities that come with that. So, residential segregation, gentrification and displacement, homelessness, housing insecurity. These issues are integral to all of the other non-human organisms that live around us as well. So our lab specifically interrogates how those societal processes, oftentimes underpinned by inequity, have biological consequences for the organisms that live in cities. Inside the boundaries of the city, amenities are not equally distributed.
Wealthier areas, they tend to have a lot more green spaces, a lot more high quality vegetation availability, natural water sources for the animals to have a habitat.
We know that in most low income neighborhoods within cities, there isn't as much green space and there's typically higher pollution.
Long story short, we're seeing that those societal elements are just as, if not more important than the ecological components for predicting what animals are doing and where they're going to be.
Many of the animals that live near and around cities need to get a little bit riskier. One of the ways that we have seen changes in behavior has been how animals navigate cities. They cross roads at times where the density of cars is reduced. They also tend to increase their cognitive innovation, the different types of strategies that they use to solve novel or complex problems. There are all of the other communication signals that change, whether it be changes in the sounds that are made from birds incorporating fire engines or other alarm sounds, or making calls at different frequencies. Their behavior is extraordinarily attenuated to us. Oftentimes, when you go into an ecology or conservation class, they talk to you about how important those spaces are and how we need to conserve these larger, vast spaces of nature. But by saying that those spaces are important without saying that the spaces that we live in, that we work in, that we breathe in, that we love in, are just as important, we not only are saying that the wildlife that live in those cities are essentially lost causes, we're saying that we ourselves are lost causes. We deserve the right to a healthy environment, and so does every other organism on this planet.